So we've got three suits here. We've got the medium, which is yours, Chris, right in front of you. We've got the small, and then an extra large for you, Mike.
So feeling good for you.
Okay. And so, Chris, if you haven't seen the pics, take a look at this. So I'll go through the charts.
Is anything different back here?
That is not different.
None of this is different.
The back handle, front handle, your slider, feet handle. We'll go through in detail in the next couple slides, but this is really boils down to these six steps to close the visor. We try to make it simple so you see it's not complicated. But if you remember these six steps, you should be able to do it. So first one's close the hood. So that's basically bring the hood forward all the way.
My stop printer didn't have slowly, right? Yep. To the tune of what your ears can take. All right, and then once you get, let me see, while waiting for the second pressure check to verify, after 30 seconds, so you want to go to full close, which should get you up to 3.2 minimum, right?
Yep.
All right, you wait 30 seconds, so somebody's there with a timer, time in 30 seconds, and I guess it's as long as it stays at 3.2 or above for 30 seconds, we're good to go.
Yep.
Then you incrementally go counterclockwise to take the pressure off to the rate that your ears can stand.
Yep.
And then we mess with the PCS panel.
Start right. The gas.
So why are you calling it the second gate? Yes.
Now I've had, this thing gets bound up sometimes, and so I'm going to try to leave a little room at the end there, so squeeze me.
It is not. No, we have an XL. The other one's an XL, double X, the full suit.
So this XL is a flight suit.
It's a training suit. Yeah, we've had it with these two over in events before. Philadelphia, we had it out there. We're hanging outside now.
Yep, yep. I thought this was a snap.
The emergency.
No, it's through the loop, pull back, and Velcro. And you can snug both sides.
All right. I'm going to do. Actually, let me do it without the gloves.
Yeah, that's right. Probably good. Let's do the comm cable first.
Oh, yeah.
Travis, you want to hook him up on air? Chris, you need air?
You want some air? Bob's asking.
Do I need air to be good for the cameras? when we zip I'm going to zip my helmet and then unzip it.
Oh, you need it.
Oh, sorry, where my chin go?
Provide some guidance to the visor with your legs.
Because the last time Duke was in there, it was over her face and she couldn't get it back over the head.
We looked at it last week.
It worked out okay?
Yeah, because my headrest wasn't in the right position last time.
Right.
Yeah, now it's set up and it was fine.
Okay.
And we talked about it, like, no distractions on anything. Really
so, okay. So you were able to flip that same thing to be strangled on there.
Is it kind of leave stuff at the front so when we slide it in?
Okay.
Feel free to push against my leg and hold this up if you like.
Thank you.
Ted ready to come in?
I thought I had it. Let me switch places with you.
Hey, copy. How are we doing time-wise here?
Life, you guys are going to be doing it together.
Right.
Yeah.
So that's going to be a little tricky, and I'll be able to kind of play the role of Bob by going back and forth and floating over you and helping to do anything I need to help.
So
and that, my suggestion where I'm headed with this is when you guys are done, you probably want to turn off the ERS flow, strap me in,
right,
and then turn it back on, and then do whatever we need to do to make up the 15 minutes. Because if we left it on the whole time, we're going to get above our time. Of 15 minutes. That's all I had to say, sorry.
So when we do it together, we are all manifolded, so there's only one gauge needed.